a man, with that time there is no Nike shoes, no Adidas shoes, no Puma. A sandals from the wood. Is going up all the way to the top of that mountain.
Allahu Akbar.
For what? For me and for you. For the sake of Allah and to this religion that came to us. That is the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's how much he struggled. He was there in that mountain on the 13th year of the prophethood when the people of Mecca kicked him out from this land. He had no place to live in this place. He was kicked out from this land and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him a permission to go to Medina. And the name of the Medina at that time, it was Yathrib. It was not Medina Munawwara. It became Medina Munawwara when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went there. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he got the permission from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to go to migrate to Medina, what he did first thing, before that, he told to Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu to prepare two camels. Prepare two camels. And he told him, Abu Bakr came to him to take a permission to go. He said, no, you wait. Abu Bakr start thinking that it means that I'm a friend of Rasulullah in the Hijrah. And he cried for that. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu was a businessman. He was a wealthy man. He bought two camels. He prepared both of them nicely. One day the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam visited Abu Bakr in an unusual time. He said, what, ya Rasulullah? He said, I got the permission from Allah that we are going to Hijrah. Ya Rasulullah, me going with you? Yes, ya Abu Bakr, you are going to with me. And Abu Bakr cried that a man like me, simple man, being a friend of the Prophet of Muhammad, of Rasulullah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to be with him in a journey, he was crying from the happiness. Anyway, make it short, the people of Mecca, they wanted to kill the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That was the last decision they made. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took care of him, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam took all the means of the worldly stuff, and he took the camel, they came to this place. The kuffar of Mecca, the Quraish on that time, they're looking for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Over there is a cave, that name, the cave name is cave Thawr, Ghar al-Thawr. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, before he go in there, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu went there and he cleaned the cave. Whatever he had, the shawl or the pertu, whatever we call it in our language, he had, he put there for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He made sure nothing is there to harm the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So they got in there and the spider. The spider came and they made the web on the door. So nobody will know that there is someone by the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu was sitting and the head of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is on the leg of Abu Bakr. And he slept, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. A snake came out of a hole and he wanted to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Abu Bakr said maybe it will bite the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he put his feet into that hole to block the snake, and the snake bited Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. And Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu took himself that much that he didn't want to cry, but a drop of the crying came out of his eyes and suddenly it dropped on the face of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam unknowingly. Allah, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam woke up. He said, ya Abu Bakr, what happened? He said, ya Rasulullah, I didn't want to wake you up. The snake came out and this is what I did. Imagine Abu Bakr doing all this. But the story is honestly, to speak about Abu Bakr and his family, how much they sacrificed, it is a long story. His daughter Asma radiallahu anha, when she brought the food for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and she wanted to tie up that on the camel, there was nothing to tie up anything on the camel. And she had a waist, a band, like something like this, she tied up her waist with that. She took that one and she ripped it into two pieces and put one on her waist and the other one she tied up the food on the camel. That's why she was named ذات النطاقين. أسماء بنت أبي بكر رضي الله عنها, the sister of Aisha رضي الله عنها. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم stayed here for 3 days and night. 3 days and night. Who was bringing the food? أسماء. Who was coming behind her? The son of Abu Bakr. The whole family is in danger. The whole family sacrificing for the sake of what? For the sake of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. And after 3 days, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, Abu Bakr, he hired a man who was a shepherd. And he knew how to go to Medina. They went, instead of going to the proper way, to the south side, they took a north and they went to the seaside, and from the seaside they went to Medina. Different way. And that man was like a GPS nowadays. He was a GPS of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What we learned from this, the thing is that anytime you go anywhere, don't say, let's make tawakkul upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and I'm going. No, you have to take You have to look at your car. You have to put the proper oil in it. You have to, the engine of the car should be okay. You buy a proper ticket. Everything should be okay. You learn from it. You buy everything. You make everything correct. Then make a tawakkul on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did. And from there, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam migrated to Medina. This is the place. And imagine how much high it is. Some people went high there. It took them 3 hours. But the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, those people that they went there, some, one of them, they told me a story, his shoes, which was Nike or Adidas, when he came down, the shoes was gone. Imagine the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went up, and we can't imagine which kind of shoes he had. His feet was bleeding maybe. He was hungry, he was thirsty, but the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the whole thing is done for my sake, for your sake. That today we are Muslims, this much sacrifice the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did. So this is the whole thing about this. As I said, the surah is too long. I made it very short, inshallah. So this is the mountain of Thawr, and this is the beautiful place where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stayed for 3 days and night. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk wa jazakumullahu khairan. Just if somebody wants to take a picture or something.